Hey, welcome to the Phrase 2013 Highlight Show. I'm Jim Bucher, along with General Manager of the Phrase, Karen Durham. And Karen, I gotta say, all the years I worked at a particular television station, we would cover the season for you guys every year, and I always would wonder, how are they gonna top themselves? How are they gonna top themselves? And you do it. You bring some great acts back, and if you folks at home aren't sure, well, who's coming? We're gonna give you all that and more right now, right?
So we are. We do this every year, and so I'm pleased to have you as my co-host this year.
Thanks. So. Glad to be. And we're here at the Phrase, and it's a beautiful day. Look at this. It's gorgeous. I should have worn my shorts, but anyway, we'll talk about that later. So what do we want to tell the folks? Because there's so much in so little time.
There is. So first of all, like we talk about, you know, grab a pencil and a piece of paper, because there's probably a lot of things that we're going to talk about that we want you to make sure that you know that's coming to the Phrase. I'm going to hold up this great little calendar.
Yeah, these are nice. This is nice.
And this is our season calendar, and you can certainly pick one of these up at the Phrase Fanfare store. That's probably one of the most important things we're going to talk about during the next 30 minutes, along with the great shows. It's where are you going to be able to buy tickets for all these great shows?
Right.
And so we want to talk about Phrase Fanfare.
And this is nice. Now, I was over there, and you guys really went all out. It was one of those things where you went, why didn't I think of this earlier? Why didn't we think of this earlier? But, you know, you can stand outside at the Phrase, and you have to deal with the elements, obviously. Or you could do it on the phone, on web, all that. But it's nice to go in and you can get Phrase merchandise and all that.
Yeah, Phrase Fanfare, we opened in November of 2012. And it's located in the center atrium of Town and Country Shopping Center. And so it's pretty much regular mall hours. And we're open 10 to 9 Monday through Friday. We're open 9 to 9 on Saturday and noon to 6 on Sunday.
And you can get the t-shirts, you can get hoodies, you can get seat backs.
It's yeah, really nice. Blankets for the lawn. Yeah. Actually, there's a lot of really cool merchandise that you'll be able to pick up at Phrase Fanfare.
And so
don't
forget.
And you
can get your tickets, too. You can get your way.
Yeah,
by all
that's kind of why we're here, too. So let's
tickets.
Talk about getting tickets.
So no excuses.
That's
there's
right.
There's plenty of places to get your tickets.
And for those who are used to coming to our ticket office, let's just remind you that our ticket office is only going to be open on show days. So if you decide that for one of our $2 or $5 shows, you don't want to buy tickets until the day of the show. We'll be open at 1 o'clock at the Phrase Pavilion ticket office located in Lincoln Park. But there again, Phrase Fanfare is pretty much always open regular Town and Country Shopping Center mall hours.
Yeah, and that's a mouthful. You said that. That's a mouthful. And you know what? These are nice, too, because you pop them right up on the fridge.
That's
they're right.
Right
there. I mean, you can go on the web and all that, but old guys like me, we like to see it right there on the fridge in black and white, or beautiful color, I should add. Okay, so what do we have? What's going on?
Well, let's just talk about a few of the great shows coming up right away, right out of the gate in June. We start with David Sanborn and Bob James, Saturday, June 8th. Again, it's one of those great jazz nights that we've come to know. And then let's talk about the return of Sheryl Crow.
Oh, yeah, this is big.
This is big. It's Mixed 107.7's 15th anniversary called Summerfest. And so we're going to have that. And it's also, for those of you who've been around the Phrase for a while, it's also the 10th anniversary of her recording that DVD.
And she loves it here. She said that before.
She does. She has. She said that she kind of feels like the house band, and so we would agree with that as well.
She likes it so much that she's not charging, which is nice.
Yeah.
No, that's not that much.
No, that's not a free Wednesday.
She doesn't like it that much, ladies and gentlemen, but a great show.
A great show. And then we have a lot of other great things in June. Next off, I would say that we follow with Styx and REO.
Oh, yeah.
Styx has never been to the facility before, so we're looking forward to having them here.
That'll
them
walk
here.
The house. That'll
it
walk.
Should. REO Speedwagon's been here a couple of times, yeah, so right. That's a good show to have in June. And we pretty much end the month of June with kind of maybe an odd little pairing, but actually two really well-known names with Greg Allman and Hank Williams Jr.
Yeah, and Greg Allman I'm going to be talking to with an interview, and we're going to talk about that a little later. And I'm so excited about that, to talk to the man that I grew up with listening.
I know. I mean, you know, a founder, co-founder of the Allman Brothers Band.
Oh, yeah.
And I mean, you know, you just go down the hit list.
Cher's ex-husband.
Cher's ex-husband.
I had to go there, didn't I?
But why are you going to be talking to him?
Oh, because of the Phrase Wrap. You know, we're having a Phrase Wrap. If you get the Dayton City paper, it's downtown mainly, but you can subscribe to it. Great. It's got listings of entertainment ideas all over the area. But, of course, this is going to be nice because on the outside of the paper will be the Phrase Wrap. And I actually have a Phrase Wrap. Can I do it? You ready?
No. we just have a half hour.
I'll do it at the end of the show. I promise I'm going to do the Phrase Wrap. But it's not that kind of wrap, but it's nice. It'll be kind of on the outside of the paper, and you can take it and you'll have all the information there. And I'm going to be doing articles for that. So we'll be profiling a lot of the folks that are coming and that have graciously enough offered to talk to me on the phone. We'll see how long that goes.
show. Which
should be a lot of fun.
Yeah, it will be.
So, all right.
You're looking forward to that?
I am looking forward to it.
I am
too. Kind of something a little different that we haven't done before.
Right.
And,
right.
You know, we'll be able to, like you said, showcase some of the great artists coming and maybe even a little more intimate conversation with them.
We're going to go behind the scenes, backstage of the phrase, all kinds
right.
of things
right.
That I'm excited about that hopefully you guys will be excited about it too.
So let's talk about some other shows
let's
that we
go.
Have.
And that's
coming.
Just June. That's just June.
True.
I'm exhausted after that. But there's more.
But wait, there's more. Actually, we have a lot of first-time performers that are coming to the phrase this summer, and they all seem to be coming in 1 week at the end of July.
You're right. Now, is that just a booking thing? How does that work? Is that just when they're available and you have to bring them in?
You know, you and I have talked before about, you know, how you know, people. I don't think people understand exactly how the season comes together. And you just essentially start with a blank sheet of paper, and you're kind of at the mercy of who's touring and when they're going out on tour. So, you know, if it doesn't matter what day of the week, if we have the opportunity, we're going to book them. And it just so happens that starting the 23rd of July, yeah. we've booked seriously almost 7 nights of music.
Wow.
And we expect to have a full house every night. We're going to start it off with a sold-out show by probably one of the hottest country kids going out there, Hunter Hayes.
Hunter Hayes, right.
We actually booked him back in December. He was the first show that we announced. He's sold out. So
hopefully if you got tickets, it's a good thing. If not, well, maybe next time.
Maybe next time. You know, they won't be the same price, I can guarantee.
Well, that's right. That's right, yeah.
But we have in July, when you look at that week, we start off with Hunter Hayes, and then I think you're also going to maybe potentially interview these guys, too, coming Wednesday, July 24th.
Right, this is big too.
Steely Dan.
Steely Dan, one of my all-time favorites. I mean, Peg, you can go down the list of songs. I mean, it's and for all generations, it really is. Yes, and I'm working on that too. They're gonna talk to me on the phone, but no, I'm excited about that.
Well, I think here's something for your interview. I think it'll be kind of interesting to tell them that their CD is what our sound guy James tweaks the sound system.
Oh.
Seriously, I mean, I hear that CD every stinking day that we have a show.
And that day, of course, he won't use it.
Well, oh, probably not.
No, but great music.
Yeah,
and that's a coup, too, to get them here.
Oh, you know, that's one of those that we've been trying for a long time, along with somebody that we'll talk about that's kind of at the end of that week. But, you know, we start out with Hunter Hayes. Wednesday night, Steely Dan. Thursday is American Original and Brian Wilson.
Yeah, Brian Wilson.
With the Beach Boys, and he'll be here with Al Jardine and David Marks, who were actually two of the original Beach Boys with them as well.
A lot of behind-the-scenes things there we don't want to talk about.
Anybody who knows anything about
the Beach Boys
knows that.
But that's nice. Iconic. I mean, how do you describe him? I mean, the songwriting that came out of this guy.
And not just with the Beach Boys, but he had a fabulous solo career as well.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Looking forward to having Brian Wilson here on Thursday, July 25th. And then a big 40-year reunion with the boys from Alabama.
Alabama.
They're here on Friday, July 26th. And that show will sell out as well, and so definitely don't wait.
I know you hear that all the time. Trust me, don't wait.
I know, and I say this all the time when we're talking about when we do this show and when we do our Kettering Daily shows, that when I say we only have a few tickets left, I'm trying to increase sales because that's my job. We really only do have a few tickets left, so Alabama will sell out. After Alabama is our biggest festival of the summer, that's Swamp Romp.
Oh, this is always fun.
Cajun Zydeco Festival.
Yeah.
This year we have probably the best musical guests, all true Louisiana authentic musicians, 4 bands all day long. So that'll be a lot of good eating and good music.
So you don't have to go to New Orleans, do you? You don't have to go to New Orleans.
No, you just go to Lincoln Park.
Lincoln Park. That's very good. That's very good, Karen. I'm impressed with that.
So after Swamp Romp, let's talk about another person that we have been trying and trying and trying, and finally he said yes. And that is actually probably the most, kind of the most interesting one, I think, of our season, and one I'm really looking forward to seeing.
Yeah, Steve Martin.
Steve Martin and Steep Canyon Rangers.
And Edie Bacall.
Bacall,
I apologize. She was on, they were just on David Letterman not too long ago. And a lot of folks don't know, you know, Steve Martin, the wild and crazy guy, the movie star, all that. I mean, he is a heck of a banjo player.
Steep Canyon Rangers just won a Grammy Award this past February for their bluegrass album. Edie Bacall married to Paul Simon.
Paul Simon.
and they're just starting to tour this summer, and so we are really fortunate to get this show at Phrase.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong, they're only doing limited dates, so we are really, really, this is a big coup
right.
to get them here.
This actually is a big coup for us. Big coup for us in July, and then we have a really big name in August. Again, that's already sold out, but we are really, it's just been a really good summer so far, so that's a great week that we have coming up in August or in July.
Yeah.
And for those tickets, again, Steve Martin tickets, we don't have very many left. We expect that to sell out too. So, Jim, tell the folks, how can they get tickets?
It's easy, folks. It's easy. You go to Phrase.com. You can go to the Phrase Fanfare. Or, of course, go to the Phrase box office during the performance, right?
Show days only. Yes. Open at 1 o'clock. So any show day, the ticket office will be open at 1 o'clock.
I think Carl will bring that up now. Carl, can you bring that up? Phrase.com. Carl's back there working his magic. Yeah, we need to leave that up because that's where you need to go right there.
Well, that's a great idea. That's
like
great.
Just bring
yes,
it. There, that's it. Great. Oh, there it is again. Well, right there.
That's okay. Great. Okay, so now we've kind of gotten through June and July.
I mean,
least.
There's more?
What? Wait, there's more.
What? I thought it was we were done. No,
yeah,
we're not done.
We still have a few more minutes to talk to these folks. So let's talk about another couple of big weeks that we have coming up in August. We're going to start off August with a rental show. We actually have a concert promoter bringing the one and only Ted Nugent into Kettering.
Yeah.
He'll be here on Saturday, August 3rd. We also have the return of the Happy Together tour, which... Again, folks, this is one of those shows.
Yeah.
It tours each summer, and I believe this is actually going to be your show.
This will be my show. I'm going to actually sing. No, I'm not. But now, look, check this out.
We won't be so happy.
You won't be so happy after that. And then they'll say, we're not happy we're together again. But the Turtles, and we've got, Flo and Eddie, and Chuck Negron, formerly of Three Dog Night. I mean, it goes Gary Puck and the Union Gap. I mean, it goes on and on and on. And, of course, Paul Revere and the Raiders, former lead singer, Mark Lindsay, and of Gary Lewis and the Playboys. I mean, all together.
All together, and this is like the fourth or fifth year that we've had this Happy Together show coming to Phrase, and it's always a big hit. It just seems like each year the audience grows and grows and grows. So, again, we expect that one to sell very well, and so don't forget, if you want to buy tickets to Happy Together, visit Phrase Fanfare in Town and Country.
And really check. You got to at least go and check this place out. It's unbelievable. I was really excited when you said, oh, it's there, and I'm going, I'm like, oh, my gosh, really? Really went all out.
We've done a
round
really,
of applause. Wait, there's no one in the studio. But Karen, you and your crew did a heck of a job. But I'm going to go behind the scenes with these guys, too.
Yes,
so we're going to kind of
yes.
day in the life of. So that ought to be interesting. We'll
yes.
see how that goes. And, of course, I'll have that all out in the Phrase Wrap in the Dayton City paper. I'm exhausted after talking about this. But that's a very popular, and I understand that Flo and Eddie, they're a little nutty.
They're the highlight of the show each summer at Phrase because
We'll hit it off.
You might be able to tell a joke or two with them.
All right. So that is just nonstop entertainment that night. And what a great era for music, too. What a great era that time.
So we're looking forward to that, and then we're following it up with another kind of 70s era event. It's called Sail Rock, and it features kind of that light 70s pop.
Yeah.
Christopher Cross, Orleans, Firefall.
Okay, I'll stop.
And a few other groups. So that's Thursday, August 8th.
That's kind of a mellow night.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah, kind of mellow.
We have a $5 Friday show the next night. That's the Blues Brothers. And actually, it's really what's officially sanctioned Blues Brothers show that's actually sanctioned by the Belushi family, Dan Aykroyd. The show was put together by Paul Schaefer from the Letterman Show. And so, you know, for that night, it's a $5 show. No, I mean, you can't, for live music, $5.
You can either spend $5 on a ticket or $5 on a gallon of gas. So
Pretty much.
So
pretty much.
You make the choice, though.
Then after that, we have the Wine Festival.
Oh, yeah.
That is always one of our big and growing events.
That's a lot of favorite for folks, a big favorite, the Wine Festival.
It is, it is. Lots of wines.
Draw your own conclusions.
Yes. along with entertainment by BWB, which is Rick Braun, Kirk Whalum, and Norman Brown, along with the Summer Soul Package this year, which also features Jonathan Butler and Sheila E. That's a good night. And
Sheila E.'s fun.
She is a nice lady as well. And I would say that probably the signature name on the summer season happens to be sold out already. Tuesday, August 13th.
Yeah, Josh Groban, folks. You waited too long, but I bet a lot of folks are happy they got their tickets.
Yeah, I mean, that was definitely sold out a lot quicker.
Yeah.
Really, again, that's one of those, like we were talking earlier with Steve Martin, a show that really does belong on the Frey stage, and so we're really excited to have him
here. Josh Groban is big when you think about it. I mean, this guy's an international...
Superstar.
Yeah, I mean, for lack of a better term, he is.
Right.
And the music, of course, crosses all genres and just great.
You know, and not only does he sing, he acts. And you know what? If you don't have your tickets to Josh Groban, you still have an opportunity to see another legend at the end of the month. The one and only Tony Bennett.
Do we need to say any more about Tony Bennett? And, you know, I talked about this in an article for the KO Times. You know, Tony Bennett is up there in years, right? And he's really the last of the greats, the crooners and the saloon singers that are around. And he's still touring. And his voice is just as good as it was, you know, 25, 30 years ago. So you never know how long he's going to tour.
And he's relevant. I mean, he's made himself relevant throughout all the changes he has recorded with...
Everybody. Lady Gaga. I mean, it just goes on.
The old folksies and even the new folks, like you said, Lady Gaga, Katy Perry. Oh, yeah. I mean, and all genres. He hasn't been to the Frey since about 93. He's definitely been to the venue before, but it was like right when we first opened. So now is another chance to see him.
We saw him down at Miami University down there. Very intimate. You know, he had the trio going, and it really was. And it was great to see folks my age. Younger kids, older folks, it's really good, really good. Can you tell I'm excited about Tony Bennett?
I know. I think we talked about that before. That's kind of some of the big names that we have going on in August. Right. And once again, we'll remind you that if you're looking to purchase tickets for any of the things that you've seen or heard about here today, we just want to make sure that you realize that Frey's Fanfare is open. Right. And we are inside Town & Country Shopping Center. And our store hours are Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. to 9 p.m. We're open Saturday from 9 to 9. And we're open from noon to 5 on Sundays. It's a nice shopping environment. You're not behind that piece of glass like you are in the ticket office. Our ticket office will be open at 1 o'clock on show days, but it's a great indoor shopping experience. The folks there at the Town & Country ticket office at Frey's Fanfare are there to help fill all your ticket needs.
All right, plus Carl, ready? CarlFrey's.com. Don't forget Frey's.com. You have a lot of folks, I'm sure now, in the era we're in now, 2013, a lot of people buying online.
We do. But still, there are a lot of people who, A, want that customer experience service. And, you know, we can hunt around. Even though you can do it online, you know, we're very familiar with what seats are and how they size up and how many seats you are from the aisle and where is this and that. Just the one-on-one, buying experience. Plus, there's also the fact that you save a little cash because there's never a service charge when you purchase at Frey's Fanfare or at our ticket office in Lincoln Park.
Right. So, and you can buy a seat back online, but there's nothing like buying it in person at Fanfare, right?
That's right.
Plenty of opportunities and plenty of places to buy your tickets.
Right. So. And a few other things that we typically mention during this show is thank our season sponsors this year. And those are Kettering Medical Center, MidUSA Credit Union, and the folks from Pepsi. Each of them have been longtime supporters of Frey's Pavilion. It takes some financial support from these folks, but more importantly, it takes support from all of you that are watching and who are buying the tickets and visiting at our festivals or free events or just walking through Lincoln Park. That's what we're here for, and it's just a really great opportunity. And our business keeps growing because people believe in who we are and what we do, and we'd like to think we offer them a really great experience.
And it is just a wonderful experience. I remember, was it last year or 2 years ago, iCarly was there.
Yes, Miranda Cosgrove.
Look, I just know her as iCarly. My kids were going nuts. And what a great concert. She put on a great show, and everyone was into it. It was wonderful. And if you've never been to the Frey's, you're missing out. You're missing out big time, so check it out.
We've talked about a lot of the major names and the ticketed events we've had. But we also have the full schedule you can find in the calendar.
There it is on your camera. There it is right there. It's on your camera. There it is.
Let me run through our $2 shows. And I want to say, again, we thanked Pepsi and MidUSA Credit Union and Kettering Medical Center.
You can't do it without the sponsors.
You really can't. And our $2 shows this year are underwritten by the Miami Valley Regional Planning Commission. They have actually done something really great with our shows, and they give you the opportunity to bike or to carpool to the shows.
Well,
and
idea.
If you sign up to do that, and what was that you sign up on?
Oh, your Frey's.com. For Carl, bring the thing up. There, he's right there with it. Look, he's a magician back there.
So if you go to Frey's.com, you click on our $2 Tuesday series, and you'll see where you can sign up to bike or carpool to our $2 shows. And those are McGuffey Lane is on Tuesday, June 11th. And folks, that one will sell out as well. We had them for a $5 show a few years ago. That sold out. We also have the a cappella group Street Corner Symphony. They were on the show on NBC a few years ago called The Sing-Off.
Oh, yeah.
They didn't win. They were second.
Right.
But they also have a gentleman in their group by the name of Kurt Zimmerman, who is a Fairmont High School grad, was in the group 11th Hour, which is the Fairmont a cappella group. And so 11th Hour will be opening for Street Corner Symphony. We have Street Corner Symphony. We also then have a group called the Motel Beds.
Hello.
It's a local group, and they're really excited to be playing for us, and they'll be on our $2 shows at the end of August. So we have those. We have three $5 Friday shows to talk about, the menus.
Oh, that's right. Oh, yeah.
Which they're sold out, but we'll talk about the other two $5 shows, the Blues Brother Review.
Right.
And our other $5 show is in July with John Waite. That's a good old name from the 80s. He was in a group called The Babies and has a whole lot of hits.
I could sing. You want me to do? No, we're out of time.
No, thank you.
And then we got to, you know, we don't want to forget.
Oh, we don't want to forget First Timers, Toto.
Yeah. And Toto I saw actually at Hera Arena years ago. Years ago. But they were there. But great music. Great music.
Great music. Looking forward to having them. Again, they're one of those first-time performers that we have. Again, if you have seen or heard even our $2 and $5 shows, where do they go get their tickets?
CarlBraze.com, right there, or the Braze Fanfare. Or, you know, you can come to the box office also day of. So. Now, let me ask you this. Can you still call for tickets?
You can. It's ETIX, 1-800-514-3849. So you can call for tickets for ETIX. Again, go into Fanfare or come to the Braze ticket office on the day of shows.
Okay, now box lunches. Can we talk about the box lunches?
Oh, I'm glad you brought those up because
that's why I'm here.
Because we actually have a new box supper provider this year, and we're very excited to announce that the folks from Grinders will be filling all our box suppers this year. So the menu doesn't change. So if you've ordered them from us in the past, they're still, you know, made, prepared the day of. They're still, all box suppers are $10.
So explain how that works, though. So you come in, you have your ticket, what do?
You go straight to the concession line, and there's a sign that hangs that says, box supper orders, pick up here. And so as long as you order your box supper by 9 a.m. on the day of the show, then the folks at Grinders will be preparing all those. They'll bring them over. And once the gates open, we just come up to the counter and with your name, and we give you... Pick up your box supper.
And that's nice, too, because if you don't have to worry about rushing to dinner, or if the wait is long at a restaurant, you can just enjoy it all right there, which is nice.
Well, and it's one of those nice things, too, that you can order online. There's no additional charge, and that's nice. You can pre-order seat backs for the lawn, so if you buy lawn tickets, you can pre-order a seat back, and you just pay for it online. There's no additional charge when you do that for the seat back, and you can order your box supper online.
Okay, now we've got about 3 minutes.
Okay.
So do we want to wrap it all together now? Oh, and speaking of wrap, ready for my phrase wrap? Ready?
No.
You got to go to Phrase and get your ticks so you can see all the great groups and sticks. Do you like that? Okay, enough of that. Carl, you may have to cut that. You gotta go to Phrase and get your ticks so you can see all the great groups and sticks. But let's kind of bring it all back home now. So I'm a novice. Where can I now? I want to find out what's on the Phrase stage. What do I do? Pick up one of these.
You can pick up one of our calendars. And again, you can pick those up at Phrase Fanfare, which is located inside Town and Country Shopping Center. We're open Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. to 9 p.m. We're open Saturdays from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. And we're open Sundays on noon to 5. You can also pick up one of our calendars at the ticket office in Lincoln Park, which is only open at 1 o'clock on show days only. You can always get current, up-to-date information at phrase.com, and that's phrase.com in case Carl doesn't have it at the bottom of the screen.
Carl will have it. Carl, there it is. It's there. I see it right there. So, and of course, then we talked briefly about the Phrase wrap that's going to be in the Dayton City paper too.
Right.
It'll be on the outside of the paper. You can hang that up on your refrigerator. We'll have all kinds of insights in there.
We'll always have the calendar of what's going on. But
nice.
I think you're going to have a best bets kind of column about don't miss.
Spook's best bets, huh? But no, it's going to be a lot of fun. So really, we'll have it all covered for you. You just need to buy your tickets and come enjoy a show.
Right.
Right?
It's as simple as that.
It's as simple as that. Okay, now we got about a minute left. Okay. Tony Bennett, you've got Steve Martin, you've got Josh Groban, sold out. Greg Allman.
Alabama.
Alabama. I mean, folks, this is a star-studded season.
Plus all our free festivals that we didn't even have a chance to mention, but they're all free.
Swamp Romp, the Bacon Fest.
That's new this year.
The bacon. Everybody loves bacon.
Blues, wine.
Yeah. You can't go wrong.
All free.
30 seconds, Karen. What do we want to talk about? Oh, phrase.com. There it is right there. That'll take you to everything you ever wanted to know about the phrase. I appreciate you letting me on the show today. This has been a lot of fun.
It's been a lot of fun, and we want to thank the viewers out there for watching us for the last half hour.
And Carl for constantly bringing up phrase.com. Carl, thank you so much for doing that. So we're going to see you at the phrase this summer, right?
We are.
And you're ready to go.
Looking forward to it.
Look, she's cool and calm and collected. Check back with her in a couple of weeks. All right, guys, this has been the 2013 highlight, a show on the Phrase Pavilion's season this year. Take care.
I'm taking a greyhound on the Hudson River.